How long exactly?
10, 15 minutes. You're lucky to get one at just such short notice. Hi.
Hey, I rang earlier about a repeat prescription, Aidan O'Keefe.
Oh, yeah, I remember, but I did explain that it's due for review and you've got to see a doctor.
Who can I see then?
Well, I got a 10:20 tomorrow.
You can do better than that. Pretty please.
Last appointment's just gone.
How do you know that she needs him more than me?
Sorry?
Well, I might be sicker than her.
It doesn't work like that.
Oh, come on. It's a two-minute job. I'll be your friend forever.
Well, if I speak nicely to Dr. Donahue, she might be able to squeeze you in before lunch.
Whoa!
What's your?
What's your son?
Where is it?
Do you mind?
No, I need to find my earring.
Hmm, interesting choice.
They're not for me.
AK?
I haven't been called that since school. Oh! Mel! Happy days, yeah?
Speak for yourself.
It's because you hang around with the Merchants of Doom.
Yeah, it's better than hang around with a bunch of wannabes.
You haven't changed.
Neither have you. I know.
Relax. He has literally just bailed me to find out where you are. So don't worry. Big breaths.
Honestly, I don't think I can do this.
Oh, yes, you can. Go on.
Where is it? Is here somewhere? Oh, here it is. Right, no point in beating around the bush.
Am I in the clear or not?
Yes, you're in the clear. The drug test confirms your story. Suppose it's down to my discretion. And I'd be very happy to have you back. You'd be surprised to know that your peers and patients were very complimentary.
Surprised?
Yes, always very nice to have positive feedback. So, now you're back on staff. How does Monday sound?
Is that it?
How do you mean?
So I've just been through all of that for it to boil down to your discretion?
There could have been very serious consequences if we'd have been found to have been negligent.
What about me?
I know you've had a hard time, and I'm very sorry you've had to go through this, but I was obliged to follow the guidelines in accordance with the staff handbook.
Howard, are you for real?
I suggest you enjoy the rest of your time off.
And I suggest you take your staff handbook and stick it where the sun doesn't shine.
You said 15 minutes, max.
What's with the whole stress head thing?
I've got to get to work.
Oh, yeah? Where?
Nah, you wouldn't know it. That new cafe on the high street?
Well, I hope they keep you away from the chip van.
What?
Yeah. Or did you skip that bit of the interview, yeah? Setting fire to the science lab.
That was an accident.
It was right after you went all emo, right? I never got that. One day you were pretty straight-laced, the next you were like a different person.
So what's with the girly studs anyway?
Nothing.
You nearly wet your pants when you thought you'd lost one.
I got them for the singer in this local band playing tonight.
Who?
Take Flight.
With a girl that sounds like she's being strangled. Hey, man, whoever floats your boat. So, like, what's the plan? You're gonna throw yourself on the stage and give them to her?
No. Seeing her after the gig. Just put me on the guest list.
Probably the only way they can get people to come.
Dr. Donahue, I'll see you now.
See you in another 5 years.
That soon.
So you've had these pains a while? Here? How about here?
It's not really specific.
Okay. You can sit up.
So, what do you think it is?
You came in a while back with similar symptoms.
Yeah, before I messed up my A-levels.
Do you think it might be the same thing? Social anxiety and stress can cause stomach pains and nausea. I hope I'm not boring you.
Sorry, I'm really late for work. I was kind of hoping you could just give me something.
Yeah, it's not as simple as that. I can talk you through some relaxation techniques that you can try.
Yeah, I've really got to go.
Right, well, I'm sure your boss will understand.
Trust me, I'm already skating on thin ice as it is. It's not easy getting a job looking like this.
Oh.
Dr. Donahue, I'll see you now. Oh, hey, Aidan, you've left your stuff.
Oh, my earrings just gone.
You've been messing about with them all morning. It's probably on the floor.
Excuse me.
Oi! I'm so sorry.
Come on, just vanish. Someone's seen it or trousered it.
Well, let's not jump to conclusions.
No, someone's nicked it. I know they have.
It's hardly likely. I'll have a look around for it and I'll leave a note for the cleaner.
No, 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 I need it tonight. It's really important. Phone me as soon as you find it.
What about your appointment?
Hope I'm not disturbing you.
Well, this time on hands, I've got to find something to do.
Right, I'm all showered and ready.
Oh, it's you. Aisha was just going to give me a pedicure. I didn't realise the time.
Oh, thought we were going to check out that new coffee shop you mentioned. Yeah, one with the nice cakes.
Yes, look, I'm a bit tired, to be honest. I had a bit of a rough night.
You feeling?
Yeah, yeah, fine. I just thought maybe we could, you know, have a cup of tea here. No, we should go out. Okay, 2 minutes.
Well, if pressed, it would have to be the fallen warrior from the Temple of Fire.
Go on.
The pathos of a strong man, heroic to his last breath.
Still not a patch on the townly Discobolus. The athletic ideal, the chest muscles taut, body heaving as he readies to throw his discus.
Well, it's just a Roman copy of the original.
Which makes the original even more startling. The beautiful, classical head contrasting with the straining toes.
A head that's been wrongly restored.
How do you mean?
He should be facing the discus. The geometry is all wrong.
Sorry, I'm late. I'm okay. I'm fine.
Oh, hello. I'm a doctor. Can I help you at all?
Hiya, love. How you doing? What's your name?
Sharon.
Sharon. How many weeks pregnant are you, Sharon?
39.
Okay, and is this your first baby? Okay, well, you're in good hands.
Well, I've got this, Dr. Heston Carter.
Thanks, but you can be on your way.
Sorry?
Sharon, my name is Ruma Hanif, and I'm a midwife.
And I am an experienced doctor.
And I've delivered more babies than you've had hot dinners.
As the more senior person here...
Okay, when was the last time you delivered a baby, Dr. Carter? How long since your waters broke?
About 20 minutes.
Okay, we should try and find you somewhere more comfortable, okay?
All right, where's the owner? We were talking about Grecian figures.
Fascinating. Come on.
Dark chocolate and beetroot sounds nice. Or what about green tea and orange? What do you think?
Bit of a Victoria sponge man myself.
I tell you what, why don't you bring the tea and we'll decide in a minute. Okay.
Beetroot cake.
Oh, stop being so northern. You might like it.
So, I suppose Aisha told you what happened?
Yeah, good news. No surprise, though.
Do you think we should make an announcement about a baby?
I think we should wait a little bit longer, don't you? I mean, there's no rush.
Well, word's bound to get out.
Well, neither Aisha won't say anything to anyone. As far as I'm aware, no one else knows.
I may have let it slip to Daniel.
What? Great. So he's bound to have gone squealing to Zara.
We must not mean like this.
What are you doing here?
This is CET. Anything you'd like to tell me?
Look, Aidan, I'm really busy. I can't talk right now.
Well, I'll have a cappuccino then. And yes, I do want the chocolate sprinkles.
No, she can't sit there. Not on my sofa.
Oh, I'm really sorry to put you out like this.
Hey, there's no need to apologise. You make yourself at home.
Only nipped into town to get a bit of last-minute shopping so the kids had something for tea.
How many children do you have?
Two boys. Sounds bad, but I'm hoping for a girl this time.
And how were their births?
Long. But at least I got to have them at home. You should have seen the boys. They were made up when we had the birthing pool ready for this one. Had so much fun with it.
Sharon, who's your midwife?
They said it would be a case of seeing who was available on the day.
Right, I'm going to make arrangements to get you moved.
No, look, I don't need any fuss. I'll call my husband. He'll come and pick me up.
No. I really think that hospital is...
Not hospital.
It's Sharon's prerogative where she goes.
Well, we can't manage here. We don't have the right equipment.
Well, I could nip out. I could just go and pick up a few things.
Please, I don't want you to go.
Well, I may have something in the car. Trust you can hold the fort until I get back.
I'll try my best. Okay?
Come on.
Okay.
All right, just sit down for a minute. All right?
I'm fine.
Really? You don't look fine to me.
Thanks.
Look, I'm a doctor. I work at the Mill Health Centre.
She was there this morning.
Was she? Who did you see?
Dr. Donoghue.
Right, well, I think you need to get back there and get yourself checked out. I'm going to give her a ring.
My car's just outside. I can take her.
I'd rather get the bus.
Well, if your friend's offered.
He's not my friend. He's just some idiot I knew at school.
It's fine. I'm used to it.
Well, I don't know. Scream, shout, beep your horn.
What's happening?
Cole says there's been an accident. The A45's jammed solid.
Oh, dear.
Things have progressed. She's almost fully dilated.
Right, no more messing about. I'm taking you to hospital.
No way. I'm going home.
OK, I'll give you a lift.
First sensible thing I've heard all day.
OK, Sharon, think of the word relax. And as you breathe in, you go re. And as you breathe out, lax, OK?
Re-lax.
That's it.
Re-lax. Oh, I need to sit down.
No, wait, no.
Oh, that one hurt like the dickens.
Okay.
I don't think I can move.
You don't worry. Right, where's your sink? I need some towels and can you find a blanket, please? Thank you.
Your last slave died off?
What are you doing? She can't have a baby here in a bookshop.
Well, it's better than having a baby in the frozen aisle in a supermarket.
You see, this is because people encourage home births.
Look, providing mum is low risk, I prefer home over hospital any day.
What about the dark ages when thousands of women died in childbirth?
And some of us are still stuck in them.
Until something goes wrong, there's a mad rush to hospital and a doctor has to sort it out.
Who always knows best.
Well, yes.
Okay. Do you know the number of unnecessary interventions I've seen?
Speaking as a former surgeon.
Right, OK. That explains everything. I know that sound. Sharon. Relax.
First you complain that she shouldn't have an appointment, and then you completely miss your own.
Look, this is serious.
You said that before.
That was just to get my prescription. But tell her how bad you're feeling. Mel.
He says the tailback's less than a mile now.
I'm not sure that's helping.
Well, just get here as soon as you can.
Sharon, if you're feeling ready on the next contraction, just go with it. Maybe you two could go and find another book on Greek models?
Sculpture.
Why not? Come on, Byron.
Byron, do you think when his mum was naming him, she was imagining some windswept romantic poet?
Must have got her wires crossed.
So, tell me about your boys. How was their birth?
Great. Oh, great. Although, at my last scan, they did mention that this baby's large.
Right. Relax.
Oh, I'm not going to be able to stop myself this time.
Right. Let's go for it.
So, why are you still here?
I thought you could use some company.
I hate to break it to you, mate, but if you were the last boy on the planet, and if I was maybe the only girl...
Fine, I'll go then.
Stay. Just don't do anything stupid.
I know a couple of jokes.
Okay.
Doctor, I feel like a spoon. Just sit there and don't stir, eh? Doctor, doctor. My friend, she thinks she's invisible.
Please, awful. Stop. I already feel awful.
Do you want me to call anyone? Your mum?
No.
She's right, your mum. I remember one time she got me and Mikey nicking sweets from the shop. She never dubbed us in.
Very commendable. Now, don't call her. She'll only worry. So how long have you been into this girl you're seeing later, anyway?
Ages. I've been to all her gigs.
And you've never just asked her out?
There's always been loads of people around her.
Surely your charm and your handsomeness draws her in.
Talks for a bit.
I'm still hearing excuses.
I don't really know what she thinks about me. She could just be leading me on.
Hey, your last patient's running a bit late, but I've told him you've got to get to St. Phil's soon.
Yeah, I was hoping to stop in and see Mel Roberts before the meeting and I'll see how she's doing.
Poor girl.
Did that boy go with her in the end?
Well, as long as he's not pestering me, I don't care.
I reckon he's all front. What do you think's going on between those two?
I've absolutely no idea, but do you know, even after she had collapsed, he was still asking me about some earring he'd lost.
Oh, regular knight in shining armour, that one.
Mm. I can see his head.
Yeah?
Yeah? I'm going to call him a he for now. Is that okay, Sharon? He likes being tickled.
Relax. Oh, I can feel another one coming.
Okay, push. Sharon, can you stop pushing for a moment?
Is everything okay?
Everything's good. Could you just give us a second opinion as a surgeon, GP, whatever you are? So, sip of water, something stronger. Can we have some water in here?
I'd really rather...
You saw the turtle sign?
The appearance and retraction of the fetal head. The baby's shoulder is being obstructed by her pelvis.
Okay, we need to work with Sharon, help get her into the right position.
It's not that simple.
If Sharon feels confident, her body will find a way.
And if it doesn't? Do I need to remind you what's at stake here? The baby could be starved of oxygen and suffer paralysis, let alone the damage to Sharon herself. I'm calling the ambulance now.
Fine. But until it comes, we keep trying.
Hello.
Hey, how are you feeling?
Well, I've been prodded, and I've been bled, and I've been shipped off for an X-ray.
Do they know what's wrong with you yet?
No. Still none of that compares to listening to him drivelling on.
It's worse than community service.
Know about that, would you?
Could you give us a moment alone, please?
You mean I'm free? Oh.
Mal, can I ask you something?
Okay.
Did you take Aidan's stud earring?
What would I want with that? No?
Are you sure?
Yeah, well, I'm not some kind of thief, if that's what you mean.
No.
Yeah, it's supposed to be quite nice this weekend. A bit chilly, but yeah, nice overall. What are you thinking?
Here's your cake.
Thank you. She's drunk.
Thank you.
Ambulance could be half an hour. The roads are still backed up.
All right, thanks. Anything?
Ah, got it.
What is it? What's wrong?
No, it's fine. Just need to check something. Baby's heart rate is falling. It's becoming distressed.
Right.
We need to get it out now,
even if it means breaking the clavicle.
Surely that's the last resort. Couldn't we try the McRoberts manoeuvre first?
OK, your last chance.
So I've just seen your x-rays.
Yeah.
Did you know that metal objects show up really clearly?
Well, that's weird, because we haven't had any metal.
Something you swallowed is lodged in your food pipe, and that's what's causing the stomach pains and the feelings of sickness.
Is that bad?
Well, you're not out of the woods yet, but it should just pass down naturally and you'll be all right. Until then, though, the doctors need to monitor you. Mel, can you talk to me about it?
About what?
Have you heard of a condition called pica?
No.
It's where people have this abnormal desire to consume objects that aren't food and have no nutritional value. In your case, metal. What? What is it?
Why on earth would anyone eat metal?
Okay, it's not a good time, all right?
You mean like my stud? Come on, this is a joke,
look,
right?
Look, I told you, I'm crazy.
I thought you meant a bit weird, not all out nuts.
Yeah, well, now you know, so there's a door.
Don't do anything hasty, all right? We can talk about it.
Just go!
Do we really have to do this?
Ready? Sharon, with the next contraction, push.
Did it move?
Okay. Next big push. We're getting this baby out, Sharon.
You can do this. I know you can.
Just try rocking.
Good idea. Okay. Push as hard as you can.
Shoulders through.
I don't really know why I do it. It just sort of happens sometimes.
Like today?
Yeah, seeing Aiden today, like, really set me off. Believe it or not, me and him used to be pretty good mates.
What, changed?
I did.
Why?
Mum died.
I'm so sorry.
It's okay. She had cancer. It was just the two of us, so after that, I just shut the world out.
Well, no one knows how they're going to react to something as terrible as that.
I bet they don't start eating metal.
Your form of pica is a compulsive behaviour. It's a way of coping.
This isn't coping.
Look, it's going to take a long time. But the doctor here will refer you to the hospital psychiatrist. Now, do you think you're going to be able to accept her help?
Well, it's hard. I've been pushing people away for so long.
What about Aiden?
I don't know.
Do you want me to see if he's still out there?
Okay.
Look, I will call in tomorrow, see how you're doing. In the meantime, look after yourself, all right? Bye.
He's beautiful.
Hey.
Congratulations. The male form is so infinitely superior.
Byron.
It's all right. Oh, I was fully expecting another boy. I couldn't care less, to be honest. Just as long as he's healthy and happy.
Exactly.
Thought of any names?
Not yet.
You could always call him Byron.
Oh, at last.
Oh, gosh, sorry, was I...
Snoring, yes.
I'm sorry, Howard.
It's my fault for being such terrible company.
No, I was really interested in them. What was it? The weather, and then before that, the breakup of the PCTs.
I'm very good at this, Emma.
No, come on, I've had a lovely afternoon.
Really?
Yes. Look, we're in this really weird situation where we know each other really well, but we're having to start afresh.
Yes, boss.
We're not a couple of teenagers on the first date. You don't have to impress me.
Well, it'd help to keep you awake for a start.
I did warn you I was tired.
Oh, and that would happen if I was George Clooney's sire, would it?
No, certainly not. Let me make it up to you, this weekend.
What do you have in mind?
Well, we could go for a nice walk around Kingsbury Lakes. They're supposed to be beautiful this time of year. You know, we could pop into the pub afterwards. You could have a pint.
Sounds good.
Mm. Oh. Beetroot cake.
That was lovely, that.
Mm, I bet it was.
It was?
Hey, what are you doing here?
Doctor, doctor, you have to help me out. Certainly. Which way did you come in?
Oh, they're getting worse and worse and worse.
Thanks.
Fess up. You thought you'd come and go up at the weirdo.
We're all a bit weird, aren't we? I mean, some of us more than others. So.
Oh, the doctor said you should have your stub back any time now, by the way.
You can have the other room if you like.
Why? What happened to the romance of the century?
She changed her status. Says she's in a relationship with Lewis Payne. Do you remember him?
That prat.
Finally, something we agree on.
Yeah, well, it does take a lot to be worse than you.
St. Phil's call, and you better be there.
Well, goodbye, then.
Goodbye, Dr. Carter.
Heston.
I'm privileged.
Come on.
So, are you going to go into work on Monday and take all the credit for this?
I wouldn't dream of it.
I know how you doctors like to big up your roles. Trust me, I'll be forgotten.
You've always been a bit hard on them.
No, I haven't.
Yes, you have.
All right, you're right.
Yes, I am.
In speaking as a woman, an air of mystery is very appealing. You say you are a doctor.
Hello?
Wait, Wyatt. Excuse me?
Thanks for nothing, you sanctimonious old Jobsworth.
Tonight, Kathy pushes ahead with